Hey creative people, today I'm going to paint this jewelry box with pearls. I hope you'll enjoy it, so please subscribe, share and like. Okay, so this is a part three and I have a sketch of this jewelry box. And first, I'm gonna block everything. So today I'm going to be using pretty much the same colors. Maybe introduce some of that, but we'll see. So like a previous black titanium, white unbleached titanium, brown, dark blue, magenta, yellow oxide, cadmium yellow, burnt sienna, and crimson red. So first, start with black for using that brush, and I sketch this with a ruler. Mark this part with pure black. I'm gonna glaze that later. So here is the inside the box. I'm going over these pearls, but it's fine. Than form orientation, that's all. Okay. Such as pure black. Inside the box and later fill it with pearls. Okay. That black and brown. Some salt color. But I'm using the sharp edge of this flat brush, it's really useful. I'm not worried about right color now, just to block this. brush. It's a smaller flat brush, clean it. Good. Unleash the denim and brown. Brush. Cool. This too, to just remove those hard lines because this is a shadow. Okay. And easy, and be patient with that. Okay. Back to my paper brush, a little bit water. Thank you. small brush. Be sure that you have this line really clean. I'm going to slide between my two color. Pulling down this paint, barely touching the canvas. Let's try. And I can add shadow. My purple. Black, dark blue, and magenta. Shadow here. I'm going to clean my brush and I'll see. This. Okay. Take this same color and glaze over this black inside. Just please. as we have. This line between the box and the shadow. Okay, it's on this a little bit. This is nice and dry. I'll take mine. And let's again put this part here. So I'm going to take a little bit of Sienna. Oxide here. And I'm gonna bring these two together. With a light touch, I'm blending them together. Small more brush, and that's it. Well, using unbleached titanium. There. Sienna. This is just a touch of that Sienna. Cover this. Here. It's going to be really dark, but I wanna touch of that Sienna under. In shadow, but with this we are creating so much depth because we have some light there, but the highlights will come from the lamp, so I'm adding just a touch of that Sienna. Okay. Take my Sienna and glaze over this part here, although I'm not worrying about this part at all because it's going to be covered by pearls, but I want that harmony. Try with this angle brush. I'm understanding and clean these lines because I can see here some rough lines. Okay, this it's not still completely dry, and I don't wanna ruin this. So I'm gonna let this dry. Can I bleach the tenon? I'm using my angle brush. Mm-hmm. brown, warm, darker color. Very tip of my brush, barely touching canvas to create that line and make that shadow here and here too. I have some hard line here. And add that right there. Sienna and Oxide mix them together. I'm using pretty dry brush to create some texture there, because this is wood. Take a little bit of this brown. And here and there add some lights. Okay. And outside. take my dark color mixed with Sienna. Okay, let this dry because I'm gonna lift that color. Meantime, I can block my pearls. So I'm gonna take this is round brush number. I don't know. You'll see that number 4? Yeah, 4. Okay, so for that. White. Create some grayish tone, not too dark. These pearls and these pearls needs to be bigger. This is much better. and add these pearls, and just I'm gonna speed up this part. I just need to think about clean lines. Okay. Not about color or anything else, just shape, of course, perspective, and clean lines. Okay, so I'm gonna stop. Recording this because this is a lot of work, but it's boring to watch circles and circles and circles. So I'm gonna block these pearls and come back. So just think about clean lines and be sure that you have enough. See, these are bump lines, so that means that I don't have enough paint or enough water. Just think about that. And of course, if you have one pearl in front of this other, you won't be able to see this one. So think about that. Okay, I'll block this now.
I'll
be back. This. Pearls, and meanwhile, this is dry. So, take my yellow. Go over. We don't need too much water with this yellow because it's pretty transparent color. Oxide. Sienna. And actually, mix our purple with blue and magenta. A little bit of that purple here. Oxide. Okay. I'm gonna take my round brush like dark, using a little bit heavier. Thank you. love it light. Dry brush and to make a few highlights. Okay. My blue satin. Let's move to the pearls. Take my round brush. Pearls are white and reflected, so I'm gonna pick the colors from the other things in the painting and bring to the pearls. So for the shadow, okay, let's go with shadow. So there's the blue. And magenta and white and touch of black. this because we have that source of light from the top and this side. Wet. And same color, just more white. There. Everyone with this technique. So one more, same color. create texture and to add a little bit of that harmony into the painting. This is too bright, so add the darker blue there. Actually, before that, I can add first highlight. Take pure white. I'm gonna glaze that later. And completely dry. Take my brush. Take a little bit of this glazing medium and from Sienna. And like I said earlier, pearls are really reflective. orangey colour. Oxide. Be careful with yellow oxide. Okay. Take yellow. Some highlights here, not too much. Okay. I like it. How about this dry? Be sure that every previous layer is dry. Shadow. More blue here.
Okay, this is still wet. Guess I really need to let this dry completely. Because start to lift that paint. Just wanna clean this edge a little bit, so I'm gonna take a bleach. I'll let this dry completely. Completely. Let's file this. Take my brush. Don't cover all or your dark medium. Just look a bit highlight. bit of yellow oxide for these here. Mix some purple and blue and magenta. Of course, more on blue side. Thank you. You are pretty close to the end. Of course, we can work this till you are completely satisfied. But I think this is pretty good. Be sure that you have clean lines. Dear, like this part here, unleash the tin and yellow oxide. Much better. Lighter. Purple here. Clean this line here. I take my brown, a little bit of blue, and just clean it. A little bit depth and it's more beautiful. Sometimes I'm patient and the acrylics really need to be patient. Wait to dry that previous layer and red. Not everywhere. No. Okay, good. I'm good with this. So, I hope you like it. If you do, please subscribe, share and like, and thank you for watching.